So let's now take a look at the three classic categories of machine learning. And we will do that because it's actually useful to know about these terms. So for example, if you read textbooks later on or take other classes, these will be the three terms that are commonly used in the literature. So one classic category of machine learning is supervised learning. Supervised learning essentially describes the task of making predictions. So in supervised learning, we usually are given data and the corresponding labels that we want to predict. And the given labels are then used for training the model. The second classic area of machine learning is unsupervised learning. In unsupervised learning, we don't have any labels for the data. So unsupervised learning is usually used to describe application areas such as clustering or compressing data. And then when we think back of the four application areas that we previously discussed, the application of generating new data, this would sit somewhere in between supervised learning and unsupervised learning. That's because there are some methods for generating new data that are based on supervised learning, and some other methods are based on unsupervised learning where no label information is used. The third classic category of machine learning is reinforcement learning. So that's related to learning the series of actions that we previously discussed when we, for example, build robots to navigate complex environments. So let's now zoom further into supervised learning, which will be the focus of this course. Unsupervised learning and reinforcement learning are also very interesting, but really they are a little bit out of the scope of this class because they are also big areas themselves and they would deserve a separate class. So in the next video, we will see how the typical supervised learning workflow looks like.